Look at it. Hey, there it is. Look at it. Look at that sunshine. It's a little chilly. A little bit chilly. But still a good... You want to know why it's such a good day? Because I'm breathing. I'm alive. I woke up this morning. I was like... I'm alive. I don't know why. You ever have that? You just wake up and you just like suck that air into your lungs. You're like... It's just good to be alive. No, am I the only one? No?
Well, I'm weird.
So we are, this is the Flying J we're at here. In Fort, excuse me. In Fort, no, they actually gave a name to it. Fort Erie, Ontario. Just over the border from the United States of America. If you go that way, oh, we'll adjust, there you go. Past Papineau over there. Out of the parking lot, about 10 minutes that way, you would cross a river and you would be in the United States of America. But we're in Canada. So, we gotta wait here today because we gotta unload tomorrow morning. Early tomorrow morning. Goody. But we're unloading in Hamilton. So today, well, it's a weekend, we got a day off, we might as well do some laundry. I know I did it just a little while ago. I haven't even cleaned up my laundry from last time yet, but we're gonna do laundry again just because Diesel's in a shedding phase and it's bothering me. So I gotta go outside and, you know, dust off the blanket, get all the hair off the blanket and stuff, and then bring it in there and wash it. Plus it gives me that fresh laundry smell, you know what I mean? So that's what we're gonna do today. That, and we're setting up our Christmas decorations today. And at least some of them. I don't know if I'll put the wreath on the grill yet, but I'll show it to you anyways and we'll figure it out. November 2nd today, so is it too early to set up Christmas decorations? When do you guys set up your Christmas decorations?
This is the laundry room. They actually got some modern machines at this one, which is kind of nice. Look at this, actually. Tell you what's going on, unlike the other place where it's too old. We have two loads to wash and we'll do one load in the dryer.
Well, guys, what do you think? You have no idea how long it took to do that. You gotta be careful putting it on here. It's got lights in it, you see? But the lights will only be lit up when I'm parked, obviously. I'm pretty sure. And then you gotta be sure because this garland here had to go around this camera, and I didn't want the camera to pick up any of it. And you also gotta make sure all your vents are open so that they can get to the window, right? Otherwise your windows will fog up. So I went around the GPS, under the fan. Here I got it clipped onto here so that... Oops, so that one there is still open, that vent. Gotta make sure that vent stays open so that I can reach the whole window. And also it comes up here a little bit so that vent is open there. You see it? Yeah. It goes up there a little bit. And then it lights up. I'll show you it once it gets dark. It'll light up on my dash there. So I have one more like that yet. And I'm not too sure where to put it. I might hang it from here. I don't know yet. I don't know how I would hang it from there. I could be creative and just start using hangers. Yeah, that's what we've been up to. So I've still got to wrap this around there. That whole thing, I just remembered that now, so that'll be fun. Other than that, yeah.
Christmas decorations are coming along.
There we go, it's feeling Christmassy in here already. Now we just need some Christmas carols. Yeah, and those vents, the camera is still clear, the vents are still clear. Another vent in there, another vent there, so the window can still get defogged. The first piece of Christmas decoration is finished. I can't wait to plug it in once it gets dark. Alright, so I just posted the picture of my nice little Christmas decoration there. Of course, there's a bunch of people saying, "Hey, that's obstructing your view, obstructing your view." I knew that was coming. I knew that was coming. So, I'm gonna show you and ask you, this is eye level for me. Is this obstructing my view? No.
It's not. Might be obstructing my view, like once my steering wheel's down here. Might be obstructing the view of my hood here. But I don't need to see my hood while I'm driving anyways. It's those super truckers with the visors down to here, and then their long straight hoods. All they got is like this little crack to look through. That's the people I worry about. Don't worry. Don't worry. We all decorate our trucks somewhat up here. I shouldn't say we all do. A lot of us do anyways.
It's all like this. I made sure my vents are clear. Don't worry, I thought this through.
It seems some people think that I don't think things through. It was brought to my attention on Facebook as I posted this picture that most people say, hey, you're not supposed to put up Christmas decorations until after Remembrance Day. One guy even said it's disrespectful. What? Remembrance Day is the day we remember why we can put up these decorations. We remember the fallen soldiers, why they fell, why they died, why they fought. They fought so that we can celebrate Christmas among many other freedoms that we enjoy. So yes, I think putting up a little bit of Christmas is a way of saying thank you to our soldiers who fought for that very reason, that I can do that. Remember and say maybe I'll get some poppies and I'll hang some poppies throughout here and make sort of like a poppy wreath. Sort of like my way of saying thank you for fighting for my freedom so that I can celebrate Christmas.
Absolutely.
But we're gonna wait for the wreath and any more Christmas decorations, I think, until after Remembrance Day. And then we're just gonna go nuts. I was gonna wait till after then anyways, because I don't want the whole truck to be decked out for 2 months. A month and a half though, we'll wait 2 weeks. 2 weeks, we'll add a little bit more to it. I'm excited. Gotta wait till my next check so we can go buy more stuff.
So it ended up here instead. I like it better there. What do you think? What do you think? Put it up there instead. I like it. I wish I had a wide angle lens. Oh wait, I do!
Look at that, eh?
Wait, let's turn off all the other lights. Let's turn off this light back here. Turn it off. See how this GoPro picks this up. I'm gonna turn this off now. Okay, you guys ready? Yeah. I like it. I do.
So today's been a day of, well, you saw it. Day of pretty much nothing. Oh, my videos are uploaded right on. We're all caught up again. Yeah, man, that uploaded fast. Come on, mouse work. Right. Oh, wait, no. Still got 62% on this one. I don't know if that's the title it's going to keep, but that was yesterday's vlog where I went shopping for Christmas decorations. And Christmas decorations already? I don't know what I'm going to name today's. Oops, your lens there is going all over. I don't know what I'm going to name today's. I should call today's Christmas decorations already, right? It's hard for me to pick titles sometimes. Sometimes I just pick whatever first word comes to my mind. That's the title. I don't know what to title my vlogs. I don't know. It's a vlog. Just watch it. It's a vlog. But I gotta name it something, right? I tried to give it a title of something that was pretty prominent or dominant in the vlog so that it sort of makes sense, but sometimes the title has nothing to do with it. I'm surprised I never get any comments. Like, why did you call it that? Really, I don't know. I just call it whatever I want. It's my vlog, I can call whatever I want. Don't need a reason. So what do you guys think of my beard that's been coming in? It's been No Shave November. I'm keeping it trimmed today, trimmed though, like this year. So yeah, I'm gonna keep a nice straight line right here. And on this side too, because it looks better when it's like two straight lines and not just one and one, you know. What do you guys think? I don't know. Personally, I like me with the beard better. I don't know how long we're gonna let it go this year. If you guys haven't been around a full year, you probably won't remember my beard. What you can do is go down below to the description. There's a link there. 6 months ago, click that link. I believe 6 months ago I had my bigger beard. You can check around that time period anyways, but you can take that link back to that and see what I'm talking about. This one, I had the beard last year. I didn't keep this trimmed here. I just let it all just bushman grow out. So this year I'm gonna try to keep it, you know, looking half decent, but I'm gonna let it go nice and long. We're going for the trucker beard. Like a boss. So yeah, I gotta edit today's video yet. Tomorrow's video should finish overnight. And I'm glad we put the decorations up here. I think I am. But, you know, even though we didn't do much today, this is my life, and the vlog is pretty much a documentary of my life, if you want to call it that. I wouldn't call it a documentary, but a documentation, a journal, a vlernal, maybe? A video journal? It's sort of a collection of my thoughts throughout the day. And I just sort of, whenever I have this weird thought in my head, I say it to the camera, and later on I pick and choose the good ones and throw away all the bad ones. Yeah, it's so nice. On a vlog, you get to edit things before people actually hear what you say. So if you say something stupid, you can just pretend like it never happened, and it really never happened. I love that. I wish you could do that in real life. Can you imagine being able to, like, what, 1 second. Backspace. Let's start this again. Man, that'd be awesome. Sometimes you just say stuff, and you're like, that was pretty stupid. Or maybe you said something and you're like, man, that's kind of mean. But I get fired up over little things too. I'm passionate about some politics. And if people get me going on politics and stuff, look out. Look out, because I was born beginning of April. I am Aries. I will come charging through like the ram I am. I will ram anyone that's in my way. I am the definition of Aries. But, anyways. That's why it's nice on the vlog. I can edit those parts out. But you know what? That probably shouldn't go on the internet. Nope. Not going on the internet. Goodbye. Oh, Diesel. Good thing I don't have to edit anything you say, because you always say the right things.
Well, thanks, man. I try real hard, but it's really all you, man.
Nah, I got nothing to do with it. What are you talking about? So, tomorrow, we're actually not even going that far tomorrow. Tomorrow, we're driving an hour to Hamilton from here in Fort Erie. We're going to unload one box. Inbox. Uno boxo. And then we're going to go over to London, Ontario. Not London, England. I wish we were going to London, England. I would love to come visit London, England, but I have to figure out how to travel with this guy. How do I get this guy on a plane? I am terrified for them to put him in the cargo hold. What if they lose him? What if he doesn't like it? What if it's sick? What if he gets cold in there? That's a long flight. So I got to figure out how to get Diesel to the UK and to Europe and Australia and stuff. Then I'm going to come visit you guys. And Ireland. Don't forget Ireland. Ireland. I love Ireland. I love any place on Earth. Well, actually, no, that's a lie. I don't like any place on Earth. There are some places on Earth I really wouldn't care if I never, ever, ever even heard of or saw. You know? But, oh well. The world's not perfect. But, what was I talking about? Yeah, London, Ontario. That's where the second drop is. We got two drops there. And one is taking like 9 boxes, and one is taking 18 boxes. And then we drive to Mississauga, which is Toronto, in my mind. It's a separate city, but same thing. You know, sort of like Fort Worth to Dallas. Same thing. Different mayor, though, so it is technically its own city, I guess. Isn't the mayor of Mississauga one of the most elderly, oldest mayors around, but still in really good shape? Like, she still goes out and plays hockey and stuff. What's his face? Did a whole thing on her. The show. Canadian guy. Rick Mercer did a show on her. She looks like a fun person to hang out with. Isn't she like 75 or 80 or something? 70, 65? Oh, I probably got it way wrong. I don't know. I've been talking for a while here now, guys, already, so this is probably most of the vlog today. Hope you're okay with that. If you're not, well, you're gonna have to be, because tomorrow we're gonna do some driving. I'm just trying to tell you we're not gonna do much, because there's an hour to Hamilton, hour and a half to London. How far is it to Mississauga from London? 2 hours? I haven't looked yet. Something like that. And we're gonna park at Mississauga, probably at the Husky in Mississauga. There's one there that I like to park at. And then we'll wait till
the next morning, and that's where we're going to unload the big one. Most of the trailer is going to Mississauga, and it's going to take me most of the day to unload it. And then we go to Scarborough, we're going to unload there in the evening, and then we drive to Ottawa, unload there Wednesday morning, and then to Laval, Quebec, which is pretty much Montreal again, Wednesday afternoon, and then we're empty. And then we'll see where they'll send us. I haven't requested to go anywhere in specific. So wherever they send me is where I'm going to go. That's sort of what I believe trucking's all about. Wherever they need to send you, that's where you go. I do ask to be home sometimes. Sometimes I need to be home for doctor's appointments or family gatherings and stuff, but you know what I mean. So they might send us home. If we do go home, we're going to get our moose bumper installed. Huh? Huh? If not, well, then we'll just get it installed when we do get home, right? First, got to make the money and pay for the moose bumper. Is there anything you'd like to add to this vlog yet?
I'd really like it if you'd move your foot. You're still on my bed here, mate.
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, it's no problem, mate. No.
Anything you'd like to add? Anything at all? Nothing? Nothing at all. Last chance. Okay.
So, end of the vlog, you know what I'm gonna say. If you're new, you go down to the description. A ton of links down there. Click all of them. Not all at once, but you know, go through them. If you wanna see more vlogs of mine from the past, you can see vlogs of mine a week ago, a month ago, 6 months ago, a year ago. All the way down, all the links are down in the description down below. I know a lot of vloggers put the annotations up there on the screen for you. I feel like everyone else already does that, so I didn't want to copy everyone. I couldn't think of a way of actually doing it uniquely. It just ends up looking like everyone else's. So I had to put the links down there in the description. You guys are smart, right? You guys can just go click the little down arrow or the show more button, and there's all the links right there. And you can actually see what I was doing a year ago. Like I said, I've been vlogging for 3 years, but couple of those aren't on the air anymore because life has changed a little bit since then. So I will talk to you tomorrow at 4 a.m. Central Time, and we'll see what we do then.